So in previous video we have seen that while we design heat exchanger network, in the grid diagram we represent above pinch and below pinch region. In above pinch what we require is that number of hot stream have to be less than or equal to number of cold stream. The reason is this at pinch point. The reason is that every hot stream which is at pinch requires other cold stream to be at pinch point, because then only delta T minimum will be maintained. Otherwise, if the cold stream is away from pinch, the delta T minimum would be violated. And if we are not having number of cold streams which are greater than or equal to hot stream, then we need to split one of the cold streams in order to make the number equal to. If there is one less, if there is two less, you have to split two cold streams. So likewise, you have to keep on splitting till both the numbers are same. In a similar way, when you go below pinch, the below pinch you have, see, you have, say for example, in this case you've got three cold streams and two hot streams. So for every hot cold stream which is at pinch point, you require corresponding hot stream which is at pinch point. Otherwise what will happen is then the temperature will be less than 100 and the delta T minimum would not be maintained, right? Because if this is at 90 and this is at less than 100, the delta T minimum would be less than 10, and hence you require to split the hot stream. In other words, you require higher number or equal number of hot stream below pinch compared to cold stream. So depending upon the problem at our hand, we might need to split either hot stream or cold stream. We split cold stream above pinch region and we split hot stream below pinch region when the numbers are not equal. Similar to this, there is another rule, and that is while we try to place the matches at pinch, right, we need to check the inequality of heat capacity. What do we mean by inequality of heat capacity? Before we actually understand, try to explain that, let us try to understand what do heat capacity represent. So let's say I have T delta H plot, and I'm plotting one stream. So what is the slope of this stream? The slope of this stream, if I look at, is delta T divided by delta H. And if I relate it with the energy balance equation, this is equated to, this will be equal to 1 upon MCP or 1 upon heat capacity flow rate. Because delta H, when I take it on this side, will be equal to Cp delta T. That means the slope of any line on T delta H diagram is represented by 1 upon Cp. So let's say if I consider this as the slope of line S1, let's say S1. So this is line S1, and the slope is also represented by S1, or if I write SS1. Now if I have another stream, right, which is getting energy from this stream S1. So if I have another stream which is getting energy from this S1, naturally the temperature would be less. So let's say here, and this vertical difference, which is delta T minimum, let's say is delta T minimum 10 degrees. So this is 10. If I have another stream S2 with the same Cp value, right, S1 stream Cp is Cp and S2 stream Cp is also Cp. If it is same, right, in that case what will happen? If it is same, and if I draw it on this line, I will have a parallel line going to S1. So let's say this is S2, and you can see that the vertical difference between the two lines would remain same throughout the exchange, and that will always remain 10 degree. So there is no problem as far as this is concerned. Now let's say I have got same S2, but the heat capacity is greater than the heat capacity of S1. So if heat capacity of S2, or let's say S2 dash, right, if this is same, heat capacity same, now this is greater than S1. If this is greater than S1, right, so if heat capacity is more, then the slope is less, because 1 upon Cp is the slope. So if heat capacity is more, slope is less. Slope is less means what? Your line would become more towards the horizontal line. So if I start with this, I'll go somewhere like this. I'll move away from this basically. I will diverge from this, and you can see that here the delta T is 10. As I move forward, as the exchange of energy takes place, the delta T is increasing. The third possibility is that my S2 double dash is less than the S1. So if my heat capacity of stream is less than that of the given stream, that is S1, what will happen to the line? The line would go like this. And if it goes like this, please consider this as a straight line. If it goes like this, this is S2 double dash. So this is S2 double dash, this is S1, and this is S1 double dash, and this is S1 dash. So if it converges on S1, if you look at this distance, vertical distance, it keeps on decreasing, and your delta T minimum, which is at one end, which is 10, at the other end, that delta T minimum will go below 10, which is not acceptable, right? This, you know, lays the foundation of our next, you know, condition for placing the matches, that is the heat capacity inequality. With this basics, let us try to understand this. So this is a similar scenario where I'm trying to exchange energy between a hot stream which is having CP 0.25 and the cold stream which has a CP value less, so more slope. So if that is less, right, my CP value, my line would converge, and if this delta T minimum is 10, as the energy getting exchanged, the temperature difference between the two stream will keep on decreasing from 10 degree to some other degree, which will be less than 10, which is not acceptable, because throughout the network my delta T should be either equal to or greater than delta T minimum. Hence this places another requirement, that is above pinch my CP hot has to be less than or equal to CP C. So if I want to exchange energy between this cold hot stream with one of the cold streams, then it has to be this, because when this CP is more, the slope is less, and it will move away from the, you know, parallel line, as I have shown in the previous diagram. If the CP is less, the slope is more, and it will converge onto the line with which it is exchanging the energy, and hence delta T will be below it has started. And since it is both the streams are at pinch, that is the most constrained region, the delta T is always 10. If you are away from pinch, so when you are starting, you know, when your streams are away from pinch, your initial delta T minimum may be more than 10, it might be 20-25. Then you can always take a chance of exchanging energy between any two streams, one is hot, other cold, irrespective of CP. However, in that case also, you should check at least the extreme temperatures, so that you get to know that there is no, you know, violation of delta T minimum. So your CP hot has to be less than or equal to CPC above pinch, and accordingly, if I exchange between 0.25 and 0.3, as you can see here in the, you know, figure number B, match is feasible since stream number 3 is moving away from stream number 4, whereas stream number 1 is converging on stream number 4. And in the same way, below pinch, what you require is CP hot has to be greater than or equal to CPC, which is shown here in figures A and B, where stream number 2, which is running from 150 to 40, right, is in A, we are trying to exchange with stream number 1, where CP cold is greater than CP hot, and hence what is happening is they are having a crossover. Whereas in figure B, both of them are diverging from each other, reason being CP hot is greater than that of CPC. So the slope of hot line is less compared to slope of cold line, and hence there is no point of having convergence with each other. So another set of rules for above pinch and below pinch is, above pinch CP hot has to be less than or equal to CPC, below pinch CP hot has to be greater than or equal to CPC. If this is not matched, again you need to split the streams depending upon the problem statement at your hand. Like in earlier case, that is for number of cases, number of streams, We said that we'll split cold stream above the pinch and hot stream below the pinch. Here we will have to split the stream according to our need. And based on these two rules, right, there is one algorithm which is designed, one for above pinch, other for the below pinch, which we'll discuss next. So this is the algorithm, right? So we have a stream data. First we'll check, this is above pinch, first we'll check whether our number of hot streams are less than or equal to number of cold stream or not. If it is yes, we'll check the heat capacity. If it is no, we'll first split the cold stream and we'll come back to this, and we'll keep on doing this till number of hot streams and cold stream are at least equal to number of cold streams. So once number of hot stream and cold stream are same, we move to the next level, and that is we check whether CP hot is less than or equal to CP C or not. If for every hot stream I have corresponding cold stream for which the CP values are greater than CP hot stream, I'll place the matches. But if there is even one stream which is not having a match, one hot stream is not having match with the cold stream, I need to go and split the hot stream. So the moment I split the hot stream, my number of hot stream will increase, and since the number of hot stream increases, I might need to again check whether number of hot streams are less than or equal to number of cold stream or not. The point I'm trying to make here is that every time when you place a match between a hot stream and a cold stream at pinch point, make sure that CP hot is less than or equal to CPC, and you have both the streams at pinch point. I am talking this only at a pinch point. When you are away from pinch, CP restriction can be always violated, right? However, number of hot and cold stream above pinch must be maintained. Okay, so this is CP hot less than or equal to CPC. If it is match, you can place the matches. If no, we'll have to keep on splitting hot stream till you are having sizable amount of, like, you have proper amount of distribution of the matches. I think this will be clear once we start designing the network. In a similar way, below pinch, we start with your data. If number of hot streams are greater than number of cold stream, yes, move to CPH greater than CPC or not, no, split the hot stream, right? So split hot stream, keep on doing it till your number of hot stream and number of cold stream are same. Once they are same, you go and check that for every hot stream, right, you have corresponding cold stream which is having CP value less than CPC. Again, I am saying this is at pinch point. So at pinch point, your CP criterion must be maintained. Once hot and cold streams are away from pinch point, you can relax this second criterion, but you have to verify that at both the extremes of heat exchanger, your temperature are being met. It's like delta T minimum is being met. So if CPH is greater than CPC, place the matches. If no, split the cold stream. Since you are splitting the cold stream, right, what will happen is that your number of cold stream may increase, and you have to again verify whether NH is greater than or equal to NC or not, right? The reason of splitting cold stream here is that when you split the cold stream, the CP value of cold stream will decrease, and since the CP value of cold stream decreases, automatically your CP hot stream would be greater than or equal to CPC for the splitted stream. Naturally, we will try to split the cold stream which has a higher value of CP, right? But then it depends on the problem. So there is no generalized statement as far as, you know, which stream you'll be splitting based on CP inequality. Fine. So these two algorithms are the guiding forces. However, as you know, we know design is kind of an art. Design is an open-ended problem. So it's better to discuss few examples related to how we can make a heat exchanger network rather than keeping it to a theoretical description of the algorithm. So when we meet next time, we'll try to discuss few examples wherein we'll be applying these rules and creating the network which will satisfy the energy targets given by problem table analysis. Thank you.